How did the roommates get sorted out of the Idol Mansion? Did you fill out forms with information and likes and dislikes, like for college roommates? No, if we're only that respectable. What happened was, before we moved into the mansion, we were in a hotel, and I was living with one of the contestants that got, I think it was all random. I think they just kind of randomly put us together based on some things like age and personality. They did it for us. And then one of the contestants got voted off, and so I had an open spot in my room, and 2 days went by with nobody in it, so I was like, woo, I get to have my own room for a minute. And then a knock came on my door, and it was Kris Allen with his guitar and his suitcase. He's like, I'm your new roommate. I was like, oh, okay, nice to meet you. So that's how it happened. And then when we moved into the house, like, he and I were getting along so well, and I looked at him, I was like, do you just want to be roommates in the house too? And he was like, sure. So it worked out that way. And he probably, I mean, I have nothing against any of the other idols. We all got along really well, actually, and we got really close this summer. But what was so great about Kris as a roommate is that he's really easygoing and kind of mellow, and I can get really high-strung, so I knew that rooming with someone like that would be, like, easy to deal with. And that was one of the reasons why I like living with him. Plus, he's cute.
We love each other, man. Like, we've been friends ever since the top 36, and we were in group 2 together, and we both made it, and I'm really proud of him, and I know that he's really proud of me as well.
How do you think your friendship with Kris and Allison helped shape your time on Idol? I think with Kris in particular, it was really interesting because we were roommates and such different artists that he actually helped me in identifying with who I was, because we were such polar opposites. You know, he would take on that everyman kind of Kris perspective on something, and I would automatically be like, oh, really? And I would just kind of always have to kind of be, in the most playful way, be kind of contrary to what he was. And it's so funny that we ended up, and we would get a kick out of it, we'd make each other laugh, but it's so funny that we ended up the final two, because when that happened, we looked at each other and went, is this for real? Is this happening right now? Are we the final two on the show? Figures, right? So it really helped me kind of like balance who I was, like as an artist, my artistic identity. And then Allison was kind of my kindred spirit in the competition, as far as she was like the other kind of over-the-top rocker person. So the way she dressed and the way she sang, the way she approached songs, I think she was kind of my, like, my sister in that. And that's why when we got to Rock Week and we were told that we were singing duets, I was like, well, I got Allison. Don't you other two boys go near her, she's mine. I asserted myself really strongly in that. I don't think Kris was too happy with me on that one.
I mean, Kris, and I said to him, he's almost too nice. I'm worried about him.
You know what? And honestly, like, I think it comes across, he's really just a good guy. He's one of the most open-minded, embracing of all types of people person that I've ever met in my entire life.
Will this business change him?
No. I don't think so. I think he's got a really good heart and a good spirit. He's just got a really good outlook. I think he's an old soul. I think he's got a really good outlook on the world and the universe, and I wish him nothing but the best.